Hi guys, welcome back to another video of Easy Tutorials YouTube channel. Today in this video you will learn how to make a website that will display the live price of the cryptocurrency, and we will make this website using HTML, CSS and JavaScript, and we will get the live price of this cryptocurrency from the free API. Here I have displayed the price of the Bitcoin, Ethereum and Dogecoin. Like this you can display the price of any cryptocurrency, and whenever you will refresh the web page you will get the live price of the currency. So let's start this video. In this folder I have one HTML file, one CSS file and one another folder called images, where I have added some icons, logo and background image. You can find all these images download link in the video description. Now I will open these files with my code editor, which is VS Code. So this is the HTML file where I have added the basic HTML structures. I have added the title and this link tag to connect the CSS file. In this CSS file, I have added margin padding, box sizing and font family. Now let's come back to the HTML file, and here we will add some code in the body tag. So let's add a div here with the class name container. Next we will add the CSS properties for this container. So let's add this class name in this CSS file. Here we will add width, height and background. In this background image, we will add the file path of the image. So the image is in the images folder and the file name is background.png. So this is the file path. Then we will add background position. And background size. Let's add some padding and color will be white, which is triple F. After updating this, let's open our web page. Now you can see this image on the complete screen. Let's come back, and within this container we will add a nav tag. In this nav tag we will add one image, some menu link and one button. So let's add nav. Then we will add img tag to add a logo. Write the file path of the logo, and for this logo let's add a class name also. After that we will add the menu link. So we will add UL and LI. In this LI, let's add a tag so that it will be a clickable link. Next, we will add the anchor text, market. Next, we will duplicate this line and we will replace the text. After closing of this UL, we will add one A tag, and in this one, let's add a class name also. So the class name is BTN and the button text will be EN, like this. After adding all this content, let's preview our web page again, and you can see this logo and these links below the logo. Now we have to align these contents, which is in the navbar. So let's come back and come to the CSS file. Here we will add the tag, which is nav. Now in this nav we will add the width, so it will be 100%. Then let's add some padding. Display will be flex so that all contents will be side by side. Align items center. After that we have to set the size for the logo. So write the class name logo, and here let's add the width. It will be 50 pixels. Cursor pointer. Now you can see the small size for this logo. Let's come back, and after this logo, let's add the nav tag again, then write UL. For this UL, we will add flex 1 so that it will use the entire available space in the row. Next, we will add the nav, UL and LI. Display, it will be inline block, and we will add some margin. So the margin will be 10 pixels from top and bottom and 20 pixels from left side and right side, like this. Now you can see it looks like this one. Next, we have to change the color and remove this underline. Let's come back and again copy this one, paste it here, then write A tag. And for this A, we will add color, which is triple F, and text decoration, none. Now these menu looks good. After that, we have to design this button. Let's come back, and here let's add the nav, then the class name btn that we have added in A tag. You can see in this HTML file, in this A we have added btn. So for this btn, we will add the color, again triple F, which is white. Then text decoration will be none. Then we will add border, it will be 1 pixel, solid and white color. Then we will add some padding, like 10 pixel and 30 pixel. After that, we have to add the border radius. So the border radius will be 20 pixel. After that, you can see this button looks good. After that, we have to add some content on this web page. That will be a title, small text and one button. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and after closing of this nav tag, let's add some space, and here we will add a div with the class name content. Now in this one, first we have to add one title, so we will add title in h1 tag. So this is the title. Next, we will add a text in b tag, that will be a small text. So this is the text. After that, we have to add a button. So let's add one A tag. And in this A tag also, we will add class name btn. And the button text will be explore more. After adding all these text, let's view our web page. You can see this title over here. After that, we have this paragraph text and this link, which is explore mode. So we have to add the CSS properties for this one. Let's come back and copy this class name content. Write it here in this CSS file. For this one, let's add some space from the top. So we will add margin top 12%. Now in this content, we have added a title in h1, so we will add the same class name again, then h1. We have to increase the font size, so let's add the font size of 88 pixel, and we will add some space at the bottom, so margin bottom. After adding this, you can see the increased font size. Next, we have to move this text in two lines, and we have to change the color of this text, which is crypto. Let's come back here in this HTML file. Here we have to add one BR, so we will see a line break. And for this crypto, we have to add the color. So here let's add span, open and closing tag, and close this suspend after this crypto, like this. Come to the CSS file, write it again, then write a span, and here we will add color code. So this is the color code. Now you can see different color for this text, which is crypto. Next we will add the CSS for this small text. Let's come back and write this class name again, and then write p, because we have added a small text in p tag. Here let's add the line height. So the line height will be 22 pixels, and after that we will add the font size. So the font size will be 14 pixels. It is like this. Next we have to change this text. It should come in 2 lines. So let's come back, and here also we will add a line break. So let me add the line break over here. BR type. Now you can see this text in 2 lines. Next we have to design this button, which is explore mode. Let's come back, and you can see we have added the class name btn, and it is in the content. So in this CSS file we will add the same class name, which is content.btn. Now for this btn we will add the display, so it will be inline block. After that we will add margin top. So we will see some space from the top, it will be 30 pixels. Then we will add the background. So this is the background color code. Then the button text will be white color, and after that let's add the text decoration, none, and we will add some padding. And the border radius will be 30 pixels. After adding this, you can see this button looks good. After adding this button, we have to add some widgets at the bottom that will display the icon, name and price of the cryptocurrency. So let's come back and come to the HTML file. After closing of this div, which is for the content, here we will add another div. So let's add a div with the class name CoinList. In this CoinList div, we have to add 3 other divs that will display the icon, name and price. So let's add the first div with the class name coin. Now in this coin, we have to add one icon, which is for the cryptocurrency icon. So let's add the img tag and write the file path of the image. So it will be bitcoin.png. And after that we have to add the price and the name. So we have to group this one. Let's add a div, and in this div we will add price in h3 tag, like this. We will add the dollar and let's say 00. And in the next line we will add name in p tag, like this. Next we have to duplicate this one. So let's select this one, this coin div, and copy and paste it again. Here we will change the name. So let me add the another coin name, Ethereum. And the next one is Dogecoin. We have to change the icon also. After updating the name and the icon, let's preview our web page. Now you can see these icons are coming at the left side, and it is coming vertically, so we have to change its position and alignment. Let's come back and copy this class name CoinList and paste it here in this CSS file with a dot. Now for this coin list we have to set the position, so we will add the position absolute, then we will add right. So from the right side it will be at 10%, and next we will add the bottom. So from the bottom it will be at 50 pixel. Next we will add display, so display will be flex and align items will be center. Next we have to add the CSS for this class name, which is coin. Just copy this one and write it here. Now for this coin again we have to add the display, it will be flex align items center, and let's add the font size, some margin 0 pixel from top and bottom and 15 pixel from left and right side. Then we will add the color, so it will be the text color. Next we have to add the border, so the border will be 1 pixel solid and white color. After border we have to add some padding, so let's add the padding of 20 pixel and 30 pixel. Then border radius, so the border radius will be 8 pixel. After adding this we have to set the size for the icon, so again copy this class name then write img, because we have added the img tag to add the icon. So for the icon we have to set the width, it will be 40 pixel and some space in the right side, so we will add margin right, let's say 10 pixel. After that you can see these coin icons and name are coming in the right side at the bottom, and the alignment is good. Just we have to change the color for this price. So let's come back and here again write the same class name, then write s3, because we have added the price in s3 tag. You can see in this html file we have added s3. So for this one we have to change the color, so we will add white color and after that some space at the bottom, so margin bottom 5 pixel. After that you can see it looks like this. So we have added all the contents on the web page and designed everything. Just we have to get the actual price of the coin, it means the live price of the coin. For that we have to go to a website to get the API of the coin price. So let's open this website coinjiko.com. Just scroll down and click here developer API. You can see we have a free plan and we will go with this one only. Let's click on the explore docs, so we will get the documentation how to use this. On this web page just scroll down and here you can see simple price, just expand this one, and here you have to enter the ID of the coin and you have to enter the currency. Here you can see a link CoinGecko API token list, open this one. Here you can find the ID and the name of the different coin. So I already know the ID, so let me write it here. Here let's click on try it out, then add the ID. Let me add the first one, which is Bitcoin. Add a comma and let's add the another ID, which is Ethereum. Then we will add one more coin, which is Dogecoin. And here you have to enter the currency. You can add USD like this, or if you want to display price in another currency, write INR. So it will display the price in INR. So let me add the USD only. And after that, click on execute. So you can see it will give us data like this one, Bitcoin, USD, and the price is this one, Ethereum, and this is the USD price, Dogecoin, and this is the USD price. So we will get this from this link. So just copy this request URL and we have to use it in our project. Let's come back to your code editor, and here you have to create a new file and save this file as script.js. Here let's add one where any name, let me write settings. URL, and in this URL we have to add the link that we have just copied. After that we will add $AJAX. Settings dot done function response. Let me print this response in the console. So we will add console dot log response. So after adding this, we have to connect this script file with the HTML file. So let's come back to the HTML file, and just above this closing body tag we will add a script src and the file path. So write the file name, which is script.js. So it will connect the JS file with the HTML file. And next we have to add one jQuery CDN link also. So come back to the Google and search for jQuery CDN. Open this one, click here and copy this one and add it here just above this closing head tag. After adding this, let's come to the web page again and let me open the console. Here you can see object, and in this object we have the Bitcoin and their price, Dogecoin and the price, Ethereum and the price. So we are getting the data in the console.log. So we will print that data in this widget, which is Bitcoin, Ethereum and Dogecoin at the bottom. So let's come back. We have to get that data over here. So here let's add one span tag. And in this span we will add one ID also. So let me add the ID Bitcoin. Let's add the same thing for the another one in this H3, again a span ID, and the ID is Ethereum. Now in the third one, span ID, and the ID is Dogecoin. After adding this, let's come to the script file, and in this script file here we will add variable any name, which is btc equal to document get element by id, and write the id that we have just created, which is Bitcoin. Just copy and paste it again and replace the id. So the second one is Ethereum and the next one is Dogecoin. Here we will change the name. It is ETH, and for this one, Doge. Next, we have to print the data in this one that we are getting from this API link. So remove this console.log, and here we will add btc.innerHTML equal to response.bitcoin.usd. Just copy and paste it again. Here we will add the another one, ETH inner HTML. It will be ethereum.usd, and for this one, dogecoin.usd. After adding this, let's open our web page again, and now you can see the live price of the cryptocurrency, which is displaying in this widget. This is the current price of the Bitcoin in USD, this is the current price of Ethereum, and this is the current price of the Dogecoin. So this is how we can get the data from the API and display on our web page using JavaScript. Like this, you can display the live price of all the currency. I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like and share this video, and also subscribe my channel Easy Tutorials to watch more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching this video.